It's time to implement the red lines for the main activity. We can do one part together so that you get the hang of it. We begin by styling the list item forecast layout. The red line specifies that the image should be 32 dips by 32 dip. We could hard code the image view to be 32 by 32 dips, but it's actually the same as leaving it as wrap content for height and width. To know what the icon size would be if we wrap content, we open up the MDPI version of the icon, and we do verify that it is 32 pixels by 32 pixels. Whether we hard code it or just set wrap content, visually the image will still look the same, but in the future, it'll be more flexible if we just specify wrap content in case the image size changes. Next, we style the text. On Ice Cream Sandwich and above, Roboto is the default font for text views. It was created specifically to satisfy the requirements of UI and to optimize for high-density screens. The red line indicates that the font family is Roboto Sans Serif Condensed, so we add that to the code. On the topic of font sizes, having too many font sizes in your app can confuse your user about the visual hierarchy of your app, as to what's important and what's not important. The Android Design Guide recommends these four type sizes for consistency with the platform and for user experience. In our app, we stick to the standard type sizes, unless it's an intentional part of the design, such as the large temperature values. Hence, when the red lines say that the date text should be 22 SP for font size, we could specify Android text size to be 22 SP, but the text appearance large attribute already maps to that value. Note that the font sizes are specified in SP and not dips. SP stands for scaled pixels, so you can scale with the device font size. In our app, we specify text appearance large and text appearance small, which will give us 22 SP and 14 SP respectively. The default font color is black, so we don't need to specify the Android text color attribute on our text views. Let's look at the spacing for the elements within the list item now. We have three children. The first one is 60 dp wide with the image centered inside of it. So we can add a frame layout around the image view and set the gravity to be center on the image, that way the image centers itself within the parent. For the other two columns, we shouldn't hard code such high dip values, because otherwise the layout won't scale across other devices. Instead, we can use linear layout weights with a weight of 7 here and a weight of 5. We just tried different values until we got approximately equal to these values. The trick in doing red lines is that you want to match the visual specs, but you also want to be flexible in the code so that it adapts to different screen sizes. And this is what the code looks like for the list item forecast layout. We have our horizontal linear layout containing the frame layout with the image view. Then we have a vertical linear layout with weight 7. And then we have another vertical linear layout with weight 5. You can check the link below for the full code file. This is what it should look like when you're done. These items look polished, but we haven't gotten to the today item yet.